Now, this week we have Double Meat Red Flood Special. Hello there, my fellow mountaineers. It is I, the Mountain General, coming from Gerlachovsky Štít to make another Hearts of Iron 4 video. Because I don't know why, but after 4 years of playing Hearts of Iron 4, it is still entertaining for me. Maybe I have some mental sickness, but who cares about that? And of course, it is still May. The Slav month, the month when I only play as Slavic nations. So sit back and enjoy. And now I decided to play as Belarus, but then I was thinking about it and I would have to use a lot of fillers to stretch this video to 10 minutes. So instead I decided to, in this video, play all these three Slavic nations. So count this as triple Slavic special in separate parts. But we will go in alphabetical order. So the first on the list is Belarus. And yes, welcome to the Red Flood. Thank you, all developers, for this mod. Very cool. I got to say, I really love the overall art style of Red Flood. Especially that little effect on the flags. So yeah, we here as Belarus start with Stanislav Bulak Balakhovich as the leader of our country. Coolest dude in Bielorusko. And yes, he is the Ataman of the whole Belarus. He is my second favorite Ataman, right after Ivan Sirko, who wrote a fruitful letter to Ottoman Sultan Mehmed IV. Oh, one day I will have to read you that letter in full. But now, back to Belarus. This will be a fun ride. We only start with 2 factories, by the way. But hey, at least our early focus tree gives us some military factories. Now 3 hurrahs for our new industry. With no resources. Like, what's even in Belarus? Nothing. This is so great. Never mind, I see Lukashenko there. So yeah, Belarus is an interesting country. Here, if you want to read. You know, the reasons why I don't really read events are because I'm dyslexic. I can't read for shit. But yeah, we will also watch out for the Polish. We will build some forts on the border because who trusts Sobieski? Yes, we will build our own Maginot line against them. The Lukashenko line. Oh, just for a second I thought there was a war between Austria and Hungary. But nah, it's just an us Syria versus Kurdistan. You know, I have a question. Who needs a damn constitution? And now, here we are going to decide the fate of our country. Oh no, motherfuckers killed Kochak. Can't have shit in Moscow. You know, Russian civil chaos is always welcomed here. Russia is now battling Novorossiya. But now, back to Belarus. We have the Ataman's decision. And well, we will not purge everyone. And yes, we will do one way or another. And I think that will let us choose the future of our country. And now the decision is only on my hands. Now we don't want a constitutional agreement. No, no, no. And now we have a very interesting event. Evening at Albin's. Basically, it's a Western standoff. Now, looking through the focuses, I have decided that Vitushka and his agents kill everyone in the room. And unfortunately, the Ataman died. Fuck. But now, Mikhail Vitushka is the leader of Belarus. And also, we can start with his focus tree. Also, in the middle of Russian chaos, the Baltic general government became independent, so I will try to shoot my shot here. Now, hopefully, nobody is going to mind some Belarusian expansion. Also, we'll use our little friend Poland. Now, I think that Belarus has nicely doubled its size. You are being re-educated in our camps. You know, I got to say, I really like to always return to Monke. Yeah, no more research, because we will definitely not use it. You know, we were good friends with the Lithuanians, Poland and Ukraine, but now I think it's time to leave this interarium thing behind us. Yeah, I think it will be better for the future of Belarus. Oh, and fuck off Ukraine. I'm not giving you anything. We haven't even left the interarium and the Ukrainians are making claims on my land. Now we are free from the Polish friendship, but we are not ready for any war in this state. So yeah, very nice country we we have here. Now this will definitely go to history books. Now I got to say, how is this possible? Austria is just a beast here. I mean, they are fighting two front war. And yeah, there goes Germany. And yeah, apparently Poland wants South Sudetenland from Austrian Reich. Very interesting. So yeah, we will use that situation to our advantage. And we will help the Austrians. Now get ready for surprise attack from the east. And yeah, we really quickly need to help the Austrians before they capitulate completely. Never fear, Belarusian intervention is here. Ah, you see? Nobody bothered to protect the border. It's great because they never expected a Belarusian hussars. Now it also turned into a little survival challenge for me as well, but yeah, we are pretty successful. And even now Lithuania is down. Bye bye, little encirclements. You know, it's not looking that bad as I thought it would. Yeah, we are not getting pushed on any of our fronts, but neither do we push. Yeah, the encirclements are my best friend here. Now also we have a nice little race for Warsaw here. So it seems like that Warsaw is undefended, but I don't think we can make it there. Or can we? And yes, finally, Warsaw fell to my Belarusian hands. So yeah, now only we have to take Lvov and the war will be over. Lvov, Polish? Ukrainian? Nah, it's Belarusian. And yes, this is the new state of Belarus. Pretty nice borders if you ask me, but I won't go to war with the Russia. Instead of that, we are going to Poland with Daddy Pilsudski in charge. So yeah, we are still going in alphabetical order. After B comes P. And we here as strong Poland lead this thing called Interarium. Basically, we are just a buffer zone between Russia and Germany. Very fulfilling existence. Don't worry, me and my boys will defeat anyone. So yeah, again, Poland has multiple paths that we can take on, so we will see where it will lead us. Oh no, I think Pilsudski is not feeling good right now. Hopefully he will be fine. With that mighty mustache, you will defeat any sickness. Ah shit, Pilsudski died. But at nice age. So yeah, we can now finally start the death of the Marshal. And we are now led by temporary government. Now we have to do another great decision after Marshal's death. Well, here we will for sure decide the fate of Poland and our faction. I think the best choice for Poland now is this one. Our enemies will take advantage of our mourning. Bring forth the military government. Because we need to restore the order in Poland. And also we want to make Poland strong again. Rest in peace, bro. Now we need to share the rights and responsibilities in our country. For better Poland with Edward Schmidt-Tiritz. Now we also need to consolidate our power here. In order to make a stronger Poland, we need to disband Interarium. I know, maybe it's strange, but believe me, it will be all good. Now, maybe our faction is dead. Now we will nicely ask the Lithuanians to join our union again. Or else. Now you see, the Lithuanians are the true homies here. Now let's do the same with Belarus. Ah, Belarus, Belarus. Anyway, welcome to the new PLC. Now we will try to nicely talk to the Ukrainians and see how they react. Now I feel like I'm acting like a Western Russia. But oh well, they didn't agree right away, so that's their shame. Now defeating Ukraine will be a little bit harder, but I don't think that it will be impossible. And yes, we can slowly integrate the conquered stuff while we are marching towards Kiev. Nothing personal, Ukraine, but Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth has to be restored. Now I think we should be almost done. The Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth was restored to some extent. Now that we integrated the conquered territory, we have a big old industry and we are now ready to secure the Baltic. Now, first of all, let's secure this Baltic general government first, because they are much weaker than Prussia, I assume. And then we nicely go to Prussia. Very easy conflicts here. Ah yes, martial law. My favorite law. Oh, I have never seen this one before. Well, Very nice America, I got to say. But we don't really care about that, we have our own problems. Yeah, this will be fun. Now I really have to ask, what happened to Italy, the new Italian shogunate? Very interesting stuff. Now I think this will help quite a bit with the Germans. And yes, this was expected. You know what, they left a lot of their divisions to fight the France, but I have a little surprise for the Germans and also Hungarians. So yeah, Poland strong. We can push to Berlin. These Germans motherfuckers never expected the Wing Hussars to attack. Yes, they will be destroyed by the mighty Poland. Very sweet war if you ask me. Now after cracking their cipher for the second time, we can push again. They are no match for my grand Polish army. That's right. We are in the Berlin. And yes, we have nicely broken the Germans down. There is no escape against Poland. Only pain. Now we can even liberate Wien and Bratislava. This war is just amazing. Third time breaking the cipher is charm. So let's go. We are just unstoppable, baby. Today Poland wins the day. Hey, thank you for the undefended Frankfurt. And that's Germany down. And now it's only me and Hungary. It ain't Mountain General's video if we don't burn down the whole Hungary. Now look at that thick Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth. It's like a nice unicorn. You know, I would go to war with Russia, but I will leave that for our last country today. And that's for Ukraine. No, not this one. But here in the Europe. Ah yes, we are in Ukraine, nicely at the edge of the Russia and on the edge of Interarium. But yeah, if you look at our country, well, we are flying half the ship. But don't worry, we will reclaim all the territories held by Novorossiya.
Slava Ukraina, Roem, Slava Putin, Belorussia, Pidaras, Vienna, Ukraina, Karasho.
So of course, we here as Ukraine have multiple options here. So let us proceed forward. And yeah, this madman rents here for hours at least. We will select this second option, because you know, we want to get here. And now we have here the airport check, and I think we want to do this left option down here. And yes, this is what we exactly wanted. Accelerationist storm the parliament. Very nice. And now hopefully we will do some wacky shit in this playthrough. Now Mr. Bolbochan stepped down and the supreme commander's choice is now given, and we'll be nice and democratic. We will host election in Ukraine. You can say that we have unusual election, but for the Slavs nothing is too unusual, and the Ukrainian Popular Workers Party has won the elections, and yeah, they can now celebrate their victory. And well, we will do the Semenko becomes president, and we will let artists to lead our country, because it is called Art of War, duh. And now a very artistic person became the leader of our country. And what the hell is that flag? Anyway, we are not going to worry about that. Instead of that, we are going for an economic boom. Now this is amazing, we are almost going to double our industry up. I got to say, these are some pretty tasty buffs. I mean, our country will be pimping. Technology good, become a cyber monkey. The future is now, old man. And now, why I chose this path? Simply because of this focus, we will create a pan-Ukrainian state. Don't tell the pansexuals though. And now I do believe that we unlocked some new decisions. You know, we will try to demand lands from Belarus. And yeah, Belarus is just ignoring my emails. No matter, let's try to demand Lviv from Poland. Oh, and they gave it to me. Very nice. Also, Moldavia, give me Bessarabia, please. Or Bukovina. Ah, nice. You know, we will take out Moldavia, but before that, we will ask for Carpathian Rutain. And they said no. Okay then, you should have just give it to me. This all wasn't necessary, you know? Now the Ukrainians are going to liberate Czechoslovakia, because why not? A nice split of Czechoslovakia. Now hello there, Moldova. Be prepared to become one with the Ukrainian. You know, it won't get any worse than this, I promise you that. Now Poland, will you give me some more territories? It seems like no. Now, I don't think we are ready for this, but I will attempt to reclaim the half of my country back and hope it will work out. Now, Russians aren't here just yet. You know, maybe they are trying to push us back, but I have a trick up in my sleeve. They're cipher. So come on, Russians, try me. No, well, let's try to push them. Now, let's reclaim Krim. Ah, yes. Art of war. I don't think we can go wrong with this. Moscow, Moscow. Now I don't know any more lyrics from that song. Fuck. My job now became hard because the Russians just annexed another country here. But that doesn't matter because Ukraine is strong. Now we will also have a field day with territories that will be incorporated in our country. Soon you will fear the nuclear superpower that's Ukraine. And the last country on my huge list is Green Ukraine. Now everything is too easy with my huge industry. Now from Bratislava to Vladivostok, we rule the Siberia and all the Eastern Europe. So yeah, I hope you are enjoying the Slav month as much as I am. And hey, if you made it this far to the video, drop a subscribe down there. And tell me in the comments what do you think about this triple Slavic special. And as always, big thanks goes to my channel members, their names are in the description and on the screen right now. And a special thanks goes to Lazuli, Peanut Club and Quite Lazy for being the highest channel members.